नमस्ते,
इज स्क्रीन विजिबल?
नमस्ते,
चार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तमा विद्युषावहि। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणुजाति पुरोवेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुकुः शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपम् अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःखनिर्मूलनम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवान्नमत्वन्निति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो लय चिंतनक्रमः इज बीइंग टॉट बिकॉज लुकिंग एट द शिष्यस मुख द गुरु थॉट दैट ही हैजंट रियली गॉट द कंप्लीट ज्ञान। सो देयर द टिप्पणकार सेज अभिलषितार्थ प्राप्तो चित्त चांचल्य हेतुभूतेच्छा रूप वृत्तिनाशे तेनैव निमित्तेन उदितायाम अंतर्मुखाय मुखायाम अंतःकरणस्य सात्विक वृत्तो निश्चल दर्पणादौ इव स्वरूपानंद प्रतिबिंबो भवति। सो व्हेन इज देयर मुखलसन, व्हेन इज देयर अ शाइन ऑन अ ऑन द फेस, व्हेन वन अंडरस्टैंड्स इट, there is sukha, and the ananda which is manifesting in the antakarana, which will also manifest, the same ananda will also be seen on the face. This is the general idea given there, but in the context of this ananda, how ananda takes place, with that background the tippanakara is analyzing the conclusion of the guru. Abhilashitartha prapto chitta chanchalya hetubhuta. इच्छा रूप वृत्ति नाशे, व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट देयर इज अ इच्छा वृत्ति, व्हेनेवर समथिंग इज डिजायर्ड, वेदर इट इज द नॉलेज दैट वन इज सीकिंग और वेदर इट इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट दैट वन इज सीकिंग विषय, इन ईदर केस देयर इज इच्छा टुवर्ड्स इट एंड दैट इच्छा टेक्स अवे पर्सन फ्रॉम वन सोल स्वरूपानंद व्हेन द अर्थ प्राप्ति टेक्स प्लेस द डिजायर्ड ऑब्जेक्ट अभिलषितार्थ अभिलषित अर्थ प्राप्ति टेक्स प्लेस देन द डिजायर्ड ऑब्जेक्ट बीइंग देयर कंज्यूम्ड द अनुभव ऑफ द डिजायर्ड ऑब्जेक्ट बीइंग देयर देयर इज नो इच्छा एनी मोर सो दिस इच्छा रूप वृत्ति नाशा टेक्स प्लेस विच वॉज द हेतु फॉर चित्त चांचल्य सो अभिलषितार्थ प्राप्त चित्त चांचल्य हेतुभूत इच्छा रूप वृत्ति नाशे तेनैव निमित्तेन तेनैव निमित्तेन There is no other nimitta needed. Just the vritti nasha, ichha vritti nasha is swarupananda anubhava. In every case, there is no exception to it. The ananda is not due to vishaya, due to anything else, due to jnana also. It is the jnana which one desires that takes a person away from one's own ananda swarupa, and the swarupananda does not manifest in the antakarana, but वृत्ति नाशे सती वंस दी वृत्ति नाश टेक्स इच्छा रूप वृत्ति स्पेसिफिकली इच्छा रूप वृत्ति तेनैव निमित्तेन उदितायाम अंतर्मुखायाम अंतकरणस्य सात्विक वृत्तौ देन दिस सात्विक अंतकरण विच इज बिरेफ्ट ऑफ दिस इच्छा रूप रजस एंड तमस व्हाट विल हैपन लाइक द निर्मल दर्पण इट विल स्टार्ट रिफ्लेक्टिंग आनंद बेटर द बिंब इज रिफ्लेक्टेड बेटर इन द दर्पण Pratibimba is clearer if the darpana is clean. In the exemplified, antakarana is the darpana sthaniya when it is having chitta shuddhi. How? By ichha rupa vritti nasha. Then tamas and rajas is won over by sattva. Therefore, sattvika vritto nischala darpanadu iva स्वरूप आनंद प्रतिबिंबो भवति एंड दैट इज एट्रिब्यूटेड टू द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ वॉट एवर वन वॉज सीकिंग. तम आनंदम अनुभवतः मुख विकासो भवति एंड व्हेन देयर इज आनंद इन द अंतकरण अनलेस वन इज रियली ट्राइंग टू सप्रेस इट ऑन यू नो नॉट शोकेस इट यू नो फॉर एग्जाम्पल समबडी गेट्स रियली ग्रेट न्यूज वन हैज लॉट ऑफ सुख एंड सडनली यू नो क्लोज फ्रेंड ऑफ यूर्स हैज सम दुख देयर इज सो मच ऑफ आनंद विद इन बट यू कांट एक्सप्रेस इट बिकॉज द दुख ऑफ द फ्रेंड इज मोर. However, you try to suppress your facial expressions there and you go with the emotion which your friend is having. You partake of that. There you are suppressing, but otherwise the ananda will shine upon the face. It will show upon the face as well. Therefore, tam anandam anubhavataha tasya mukha vikasaha bhavati. In this case, Shishya should have had Mukha Vikasa if he had Ananda in the Antakkarana, which would have been possible only if he had that Yuraka moment, as in, I got that, whatever was being said, I completely understand now. So therefore, in the context, Prakritecha, Shishyasya Avidya Tatkari Nivritti Purvaka Paramananda Rupa Moksha Jnana Dvara Praptu Mishtaha. So what is the Abhilashitartha? In the case of the Shishya, Jnana Dvara Praptum Ishtaha Abhilashitartha is Moksha, which is Ananda Rupa Moksha. Moksha has to be Ananda Rupa. Nobody wants Dukkha Rupa Moksha. We have enough of Dukkha Rupa in the Samsara. So, not only Ananda which has gradations, it is Paramananda Rupa. And how does one get that Paramananda Rupa Moksha? It is preceded by Nivritti. So, Purvaka. Preceded by Nivritti. Nivritti of what? Karya. Karya and its Karana also. So, Bija Sahita. Otherwise, if Karya Nivritti takes place and Karana is there, Bija Rupa Karana is there, then the Karya can come up again. Therefore, Avidya, which is Karana, and Avidya Karya. Tatkarya is Avidya Karya. So, Avidya Tatkarya Nivritti Purvaka Paramananda Rupa Mokshaha Jnana Dvara Praptum Ishtaha. Jnanena Moksha is mentioned here. Kasya Shishyasya. This was desirable. Ishtaha. Abhilashitartha Siddhya Bhavacha. Since that desired Jnana didn't take place completely, therefore Moksha, Paramananda Rupa Moksha didn't take place, therefore Shishyasya Ichha Rupa Chitta Vritti Vinasha Na Abhavat. The Ichha is still there. Moksha Ichha is still there. He is still a Mumukshu. He is not a Jnani. Therefore, there is no Paramananda. This is the inference by looking at the Shishya's face. There is still a question mark. Ichha Rupa. So there is a typo here. Ichha Rupa Vritti Nivrityatmaka Nimitta Bhavad Antar Mukha Vrityudayaha Tasmin Swarupananda Pratibimbodayaha Tadanubhava Janya Mukha Vikasascha Na Shishyasya Abhavat. So the sequence is explained here as Ichha Rupa Nivritti takes place, thereby this Antarmukha Vrityudayaha. This Antarmukha Vrityudaya is there is Swarupananda which manifests in the Antakarana because the Antakarana isn't focused outward, it is focused inward. There is no Ichha within, therefore, Ichha being met, Ananda reflects clearly in the Antakarana. Tasmin Swarupananda Pratibimbodaya. This is clear Pratibimba of Ananda, Swarupananda. Tad Anubhava Janya Mukha Vikasascha. So Anubhava will drive the face also to give such an expression. That didn't take place. Na Shishyasya Abhavat. Tena Mukha Vikasa Abhavena Shishyasya Akrutarthata Anumita Abhut. So this for the Guru, there was an Anumana possible, which was derived from the facial expression not being there. So lack of the happiness seen on the face, he understood that the Shishya hasn't got it. Anyway, this is clear. Just wanted to show you how the, you know, even these Swamiji analyzes it. Anyway, so I just wanted to make one correction yesterday. I missed this thing. I mean, I think Indriyani, there was something in plural, Lotlakara. I assumed it as a... I just wanted to make a small correction there. So I took a this thing as a word as a typo because I thought it was a I somehow wanted to finish it off and there I made a mistake. Where was it? Athava, we finished this. I think next page. Yeah, here itself somewhere. Yeah, so Indriyani. So I just towards the end I covered this up and then went to the Moola. Indriyani Visheshu Pravartantam. So I Pravartatam is what I pronounce. Pravartantam va tato nivartantam va. So this is plural, that's all it is. So Bahuvachana, because Indriyani are Bahuvachana, Lotlakara, Prathama Purusha, Bahuvachana. So there so ittham paramartha tattve upadishte api shishya mukhe aprasannatam alakshya noonam ayam akrutartha. Certainly he is not krutartha, therefore yatha asya mukham aprasannam asya, this is the anumana iti guru nirachanot. So he inferred in that manner. Atah punarapi tam stula drushtya upadishan prapanchalaya chintana prakaram ah. So why is this needed? If one has landed on the tattva without any doubts, then this laya chintana krama ityadi is not needed. One can straight away be in the mahavakya conclusion as being eka atma, which is me, which is brahma, which is satchidananda swarupa, and one can have nishtha there. But since jnana itself is, you know, is not bereft of doubts, there will be so many obstacles. Therefore another prakriya where, you know, you give some concessions and you say that okay, you do dhyana or chintana on this tattva. Shravana will work then, the more you spend time with chintana. Jai chintane. So dhyana or chintana can have similar shades of meaning, or even dhyana as meditation can also be taken, which is upasana. Anyway, the difference between jnana and dhyana will come up a little later in the text itself. So what is the teaching now? The teaching, how do you think? So chintana prakara is being taught. How should you have chintana? So the way the srishti krama was there, this is reversed. So prapancha laya chintana prakaramaha. The tippanakara says, karyasya karna swarupatam jnatva tad anariktatva chintanam eva laya chintanam uchyate. So karya karana prakriya. And you see here, karya karana prakriya is taught in the Upanishads. Upanishads, majority of the Upanishads also cater to Madhyama Adhikaris, not Uttama Adhikari. The Upanishads where Srishti is not taught, that is committed to the Uttama Adhikari. Where Srishti prakriya is taught in various ways, where karya karana prakriya is taught, that is towards the Madhyama Adhikari. Here also you look at it, since the Shishya hasn't got it, therefore there is more detail on reversing this Srishti. Initially just the Srishti Krama as an Adhyaropa followed by immediate Apavada would have been sufficient, but here that didn't work. So Karyasya Karana Swarupatam Jnatva, having known Karya as not being separate from Karana, the karya, satta, spurti, everything of the karya except for nama is the karana satta. Everything that is there in the karya except for nama belongs to the karana. So once you know that, karyasya karana swarupatam jnatva tad anariktatva chintanam. So chintana prakara is what really seeing that every karya is nothing but its karya, karana. So you keep on doing it, that is the laya chintanam. So laya chintanam uchyate. So now we know what is going to be done, and we know this krama of srishti, it is being reversed in so many words. Yatha mrutkarya bhutaha ghataha antarvaischa mrudeva bhavati iti mrutkaryam sarvam api mrudeva. Every product of clay, sarvam api, is mrut, whether it is a pot or it is a kumbha, whether it is a lid, whether it is a cup, every mrutkarya is mrut. So mrit yatha mritkarya bhuta ghata antarvaicha within and without, outside and inside. If you start looking at it, that is due to a boundary. But what is it really? The material is nothing but the clay itself, mrit itself. Yatha cha jalakarya bhuta phena budbudadikam sarvam api jalamiyo bhavati. And whether you look at the wave, you look at a samudra, and you look at wave, you look at foam, you look at bubbles, all of those are what? Basically, water, nothing else but water. Tatha, similarly, tatha yat yasya karyam, yad yasya karyam, whatever is a karya of whichever karana, that karya, tat karyam, tadrusha karana sarupamevo bhavati. It is nothing but karana. Every karya is nothing but karana. It is seen as karya with a different name. Then we'll say rupa also, but actually not rupa also. Nama rupa mithya, true. But rupa, also if you analyze further, that rupa is mithya, the rupa of the karya is mithya. If you look at karana in the laukika, when you start looking at each and every product, if you analyze, then the form or the shape, if you look at, the shape is also of the karana itself. So really, nama is mithya. And the pada, nama is pada. Padartha has no existence other than pada really. Pada padarthayo abhedaha bhavati. This is Purvamimamsaka. Purvamimamsaka has analyzed it very well and established doubtlessly for us to build upon it and land on Upanishad also, where the same Mimamsa will apply. Uttara Mimamsa. Pada padarthayo abheda. And then we say, because of that, padartha is mithya. We'll say pada is satya. But pada is nama. Nama is mithya. Why is it mithya? Because nama is put together letters, nothing else but akshara. Akshara is what? Nakshrati iti akshara. What is really akshara? Akshara is Brahma. So at Omkara, akshara is manifestation. Akshara as in letters are manifestation of that akshara Brahma. So nama is mithya because it is just manifestation of letters which are nothing but akara vai sarva vak. The Chandogya Upanishad mantra says akara vai sarva vak. Every speech, every word, every sentence is nothing but made up of words. Subantam tingantam, suptingantam padam. So that pada is nothing but akshara, akshara, akara. And everything is consumed in akara, ukara, makara really. When you open your mouth, you will pronounce akara. When you close your mouth, you will pronounce makara. Between this, whatever is uttered, that is all included in Ukara. So, Omkara. Akara is Omkara, representing Omkara. Omkara represents all words. All words are, you know, padas are not different from padartha. So, pada padarthayo abheda. Thereby, everything is Omkara is Ishvara's name. Akshara Brahma. Therefore, everything is just a manifestation of Brahma. This will come up in another Chintana method of Upasana Ityadi. But this is a background in which how everything can be resolved into Mithya except for what cannot be resolved, which is the Adhishthana for all resolutions. Yathacha, so we saw this Yathacha. Tatha yadyasya karyam tat tadrusha karana sarupameva bhavati. Every karya can be resolved into its karana. And this is one prakriya. You can resolve the padartha in pada also. Then pada into, which is what I have explained it. How do you do mithyatva nischaya? Wherever satta is missing, if you can trace it back to something else, satta of something else is seen in the karya, then you can resolve into that itself. Need not be necessarily karana. Or whatever it can be resolved into can be seen as adhishtana or karana, either way. Need not be technical because it is your own chintana. Need not be technically in line with each and every, you know, only a particular prakriya. If it helps you land on aikya without compromising the aikya, if you can use any methodology to land on that, that itself is your chintana prakara or dhyana. Here specifically, karya karana, that karana is seen here as with the examples of ghata and mrut, and then as jala and all these jala karya bhuta phena budbuda ityadi. Tatha yad yasya karyam tat tadrusha karana swarupam bhavati na karyam karana swarupat atirichyate. So in karya karana prakriya, the tatparya is not to say brahma is jagat karana. This is where people get stuck. They think that brahma is jagat karana. You cannot even, you should not talk about any other prakriya. It should be only, you should land on Ishvara. Ishvara is jagat karana. Shuddha brahma is not jagat karana. That is why we need maya. Otherwise, maya is not needed. And if you don't use maya, which explains the impossibility, first, it will not be explainable at all. Brahma itself cannot be explained as jagat karana. And if you explain it, then Brahma will also be laukika. There is really impossibility of moksha. Because that kind of Brahma who is karana will have karaka bheda. You cannot say asanga, all these asangatva, nirgunatva, all these will not apply. None of those will apply to that Brahma which is jagat karana. So what is the tatparya? This is the tatparya. Na karyam karana swarupat atirichyate. If you can understand that, then the chintana will be easier. You need not land and hold on to one karana. It is for mithyatva nischaya. Sakalasya prapanchasya moola karanam ishvara eva. Tasmat sakala api karya prapancha ishvara swarupat na atirichyate. That is the tatparya. Everything is nothing but manifestation of ishvara. Sakala prapanchasya api swarupam ishvara eva. So what is the prapancha swarupa? Nama rupatmaka prapancha is mithya. So what is the real swarupa of prapancha? It is ishvara. Sacha ishvara aham eva. But you should not stop there. You should do bhagatyaga lakshana. That is the tatparya. Once you land on everything being ishvara, that everything includes me. That is one way to look at it. But that everything which is said to be Ishvara, that Ishvara is me. That is the real tatparya. Sahacha Ishvara ahameva. Iti jnyatva sakala prapanchasya layam swasmin anuchintayet. Not in Ishvara. Swasmin. So there are two ways to do it. You resolve the entire prapancha into Ishvara and then you say aikya. You think of aikya. Through Mahavakya, that Ishvara, Tattvamasi, you are that. So I am that. Aham Brahmasmi. Or in Chintana Prakara, since you already know this, Shravana has already taken place. Then you already know that Ishvara into which every part of the Prapancha has to be resolved, I can resolve into me cognitively. That is the Chintana Prakara. So you need not go somewhere else in resolution. Adhisthana as something else, someone else, the universal. Because it is not really helping. Finally, I have to land in Aikya. Therefore, Swasmin Anuchintayet, Layam. Laya also should be Sakala Prapanchasya Layam, Swasmin Anuchintayet. One should think of this resolution also in oneself, not in Ishvara. Because Ishvara is Jivad Abhinna, Ishvara Abhinna Aham. Therefore, resolve into oneself. This is a better methodology. This is what even Mandukya explains when it talks about Omkara as Jagat Karana and then resolution also into Vishwa, not into Virat. So you start your gross analysis through Vishwa, not with Vaishwanara, not with the universal. You collapse the universe into the individual. That is you. Because there is no other individual after that. You are the only individual who has no other. Sthula prapanchasya panchikruta bhuta swarupattvam sukshma srishtehe apanchikruta bhuta swarupattvam cha chintayet. So now you start analyzing with the gross prapancha and the subtle prapancha. How do you do that? So now we know the broad outstrokes. Now in details, each of these are mentioned. Stulamidam brahmanam akhilam api panchikruta bhuta karyam. The stula prapancha is a product of the grossified elements, five elements. Tatra prithvi karyam sarvam prithvi swarupam. So karya karana abheda has been taught. So prithvi karya, prithvi is a panchamahabhuta, the grossest of them. Its karya is what? Prithvi swarupam. It is it its swarupa is prithvi swarupa because it is born out of prithvi. Every prithvi karya, every gross product that you can objectify is all prithvi swarupa. So gandhavati prithvi. So you can think of that also. Wherever there is gandha, all that is prithvi. Meaning pancha mahabhuta prithvi, not prithvi as in this golaka, not urvi prithvi, the earth. Basically it means not that earth, the globe, but the, you know, the mud or whatever we'll talk about as earth, that jala karyam sarvam jala swarupam ittham eva yad yad bhuta karyam tat tad bhuta swarupam iti akhilasya api brahmandasya panchikrita panchabhuta swarupatvam anuchintayet. So with each and every karya one can resolve into its own panchamahabhutas. Tathaya panchikrutam sarvam api bhutam apanchikruta bhuta karyatvad apanchikruta bhuta swarupam iti chintayet. Then once you land on the five basic elements which are gross, you can think of prithvi, jala, agni, vayu and akasha. Go subtler at each level, but then still they, you can cognize this akasha. You know that there is so much of space. You can feel the vayu. Agni can be seen, jala can be tasted, and prithvi can be touched and smelled. So all of these, you know, whatever you can work with as an object, it is collapsed into its karana. Then this karana being gross, it has come out of its sukshma components. So they have mixed, they have intermixed with each other to grossify. So you can resolve them into their own subtle components. That is a karana. So from the subtle, the gross has come. Therefore, all the five gross elements are nothing but the mixture of the five subtle elements. Antakkaranadi sukshma srishtirapi apanchikrita bhuta karyatvat apanchikrita bhuta swarupam iti chintayet. Then what about me, who is a subject? I, the subject, consider myself as body mind sense complex. The body, the stula prapancha includes my sharira. So that gross sharira, the stula sharira, is already resolved into panchamahabhutas and then into apanchikrita panchamahabhutas. First panchikrita and then apanchikrita. These sense organs, what about them? The manaha, antakkarana, indriyas, all these are sukshma, but they are sukshma panchamahabhuta karya, apanchikrita mahabhuta karya. So all of these are nothing but my sense organs, are all the sukshma sharira is completely resolved into the apanchikrita bhuta because of karya karana abheda. Antakkaranam sarva bhuta samashti sattva guna karyatvat sattva guna swarupam eva. So what is the swarupa of my antakkarana? That is not atma, anatma, sukshma, objectified, drishyatvat mithya. This is what we saw earlier. But if it doesn't set in, then you understand that it is made out of subtle mahabhutas. Therefore, this samashti sattva guna of these sukshma panchamahabhutas, apanchikrita panchamahabhutas, have been put together and antakkarana is born out of that. So my antakkarana is nothing but this sattva guna of the panchamahabhutas. So panchamahabhutas, sattva guna swarupam eva. It is a totality of all the five sattva gunas of the five subtle mahabhutas. Tatha prana api. Prana is also karya. So prana api. So now I'll just go through this. We understand the krama. We have seen what it is born out of. So I'll just read through this. Tatha prana api purvokta panchabhuta samashti rajoguna karyatvat rajoguna swarupam eva. Swarupah eva. Prana is pullinga. So rajoguna swarupah eva. Paivindriyam prithivya rajoguna karyatvat prithivya rajoguna swarupam eva. So paivindriya is what? Rajoguna karya of prithvi. Therefore it is prithvi rajoguna swarupa. Granendriyam prithivya sattva guna karyatvat prithivya sattva guna swarupam eva. Tathaiva rasendriyam upasthendriyam cha jalasya kramena sattva guna rajoguna karyatvat tattat swarupam eva. Chakshurindriyam padendriyam cha tejasa kramena sattva guna rajoguna swarupe. You just keep on resolving into its own karana. So whichever guna has been taken out from the panchamahabhutas to create these indriyas, those indriyas will resolve into their own individual karanas. And this is actually what takes place in at Vidheya Mukti. So here one can cognitively analyze this so that Anatma is resolved into it, their basic components. Twagindriyam, Panindriyam cha Vayoho Kramena Sattvaguna Rajoguna Swarupe Shrotriyindriyam, Vagindriyam cha Akashasya Kramena Sattvaguna Rajoguna Swarupe Itham Sukshma Srishti Samagrapi Apanjikrita Bhuta Swarupa Eva Iti Chintayet. So one should resolve the entire Sukshma Srishti into its basic Karana. Therefore, Apanjikrita Bhuta Swarupa. That is what we will have landed on finally in the Chintana Prakara. What about this Apanjikrita Bhutas, Mahabhutas? Are they the final Karanas? No, they are also Karya. So, Apanjikrita Bhutanam Prakrutau Pradhane Pradhanasya Brahmani Cha Layam Chintayet. Then these will also resolve into their earlier Sukshma Karanas. So, Sukshma Prithvi is born out of Sukshma Jala. Sukshma Jala is born out of Sukshma Agni. Sukshma Agni out of Sukshma Vayu. Sukshma Vayu out of Sukshma Akasha. And Akasha out of Unmanifest. Basically leading to Brahmatma finally. So, Srishti Krama is reversed in the Chintana. Pragukta Chintananantaram Apanchikrita Bhutanam Api Layaha Chintaniya. So, the subtle components also have to be analyzed and resolved into finally into Brahma, which is Atma. Prithvi Jalakaryatvat Jalaswarupa, that's a typo here. So Prithvi is Jalaswarupa because it is Jalakarya. Jala is Tejakarya, therefore Tejaswarupa. Jalam Tejakaryatvat Tejaswarupa. Tejo Vayukaryatvat Vayuswarupam. Vayu Akashakaryatvat Akashaswarupa. Akasha Tamoguna Pradhana Prakritihi Karyatvat Prakritiswarupaha. So Akasha is what made out of Tamoguna Pradhana Prakriti Karya. It is a karya, so it is made up of tamoguna pradhana prakriti. This sattvaguna pradhana prakriti is maya. Here tamoguna is taken so that the creation takes place. So akashah tamoguna pradhana prakriti karyatvat prakriti swarupa finally. And why prakriti swarupa? Because tamoguna is not separated out. Maya is trigunatmika maya. It is its very atma, very swarupa of maya is trigunatvam. Prakriti mayayaha avastha visheshatvat maya swarupa. What is prakriti finally? Prakriti is basically maya. Mayaha avastha visheshatvat. Prakriti, when it starts, rather seen from the angle of the srishti, from the creation, the prapancha angle, if you look at maya, that maya looks like prakriti. So prakriti is a name given for maya when she is seen as the upadana karana of Akasha Ityadi Srishti. Ekamya vastu pradhanam prakriti maya avidya ajnanam shaktihi iti aneka shabdaihi vyapadishyate. All these are interchangeable words. Pradhana in Sankhya, prakriti maya ityadi. But they have particular connotations. Tadeva vastu sakalamipi karyajatam swasmin upasamrutya pralayakale udasina swarupena vartamanatva pradhanam ityuchyate. Why is maya called as pradhana? That tattva, unmanifest, avyakta tattva is called as pradhana. Why? Tadeva vastu, that maya which is bhava rupa, like at the individual level called as avidya. Karya jatam, sakalamapi karya jatam, the entire group of products are resolved into that vastu, maya. Kare swasmin upasamrutya, and having resolved in the pralaya kala, during pralaya, udasina swarupena, completely unattached to anything, completely neutral to anything, nothing is going on there. The gunas are balanced. Sattva, rajas, tamas, all three are balanced. So therefore, udasina swarupena vartamanatva pradhanam ityuchyate. Completely unmoved, it remains, therefore it is called as pradhana. Tadeva vastu prapancha srishti upadanata yogyata. So here tadeva vastu, sorry, prapancha srishti upadanata. Prapancha srishti upadanata yogya tamo guna pradhana swarupena vidyamanatvat. Prakriti iti akhyayate. So same Maya is called as Prakriti also. When is it called as Prakriti? When Prapancha Srishti Upadanata Yogya. It becomes Yogya. The Prakriti, the Maya Tattva becomes, Avyakta Tattva becomes Yogya for becoming the Upadana Karana of Srishti. Prapancha Srishti Upadana Karana. Upadana, Upadana Karanata Yogya. It becomes Yogya, fit for that. By lending its tamoguna there. So tamoguna pradhana surupina. The pradhana has, although pradhana has all three gunas, this tama, tamas is lent for manifestation of jagat. Therefore, tamoguna pradhana surupina vidyamanatva prakriti iti akhyayate. So it's a big compound. So I'm reading just the last part. This entire thing is a compound. Deshakaladi samagrim vina eva indrajalena durgata. Durgata aneka padartha utpadana kale indrajalam maya iti vyapadishyate. Why is this avyakta tattva called as maya? Because it is magical. Padartha utpadana kale, during the utpadana of the, when the srishti is taking place and each and every srishti components are created, but then again karya is, you know, being created every now and then. There is manifestation. So desha kala di samagrim vinayeva. There is no desha kala ityadi when something is being created in the srishti krama. So indrajalena, as though like a magic, you know, durghata, which is impossible or difficult to do. You know, you cannot do anything without desha kala. It is very mystical. Even we cannot think about anything being possible without desha and kala. Without any samagris. By itself it is sufficient. Therefore, durghata aneka padartha utpadana kale indrajalam maya iti vyapadishyate. That magical power is called as maya. Tadvad eva asange advitiye brahmani durghata icchadyutpadakatvad. So durghata durghate icchadyutpadakatvad, meaning durghata iccha ityadi utpadakatvat, where brahmani, advitiya brahmani, in advitiya brahma, how can there be icchadi? Just not possible. It is impossible. Nirguna brahma cannot have iccha, but still it is made possible as though. That is the maya shakti. So therefore called as maya. Maya iti bhanyate, it is called as maya. Tadeva vastu brahma swarupavarakatvat ajnanamiti kirtyate. Why is it called as ajnana, that shakti? Because it has, can create avarna on Brahma. Why is it called as avidya? Tadeva vastu brahma vidya vinashyatvat. That ajnana will go away by brahma jnana, brahma vidya. Therefore vidya virodhini. Tadeva vastu brahma vidya vinashyatvad avidya iti varnyate. Tadeva vastu kadapi svatantrena anavastitam sat brahma chaitanyam ashritya eva vartamanatvar shakti riti cha vyapadishyate. Why is that vastu called as shakti, maya? Because kadapi svatantrena anavastitam sat. Never being independent, always dependent on brahma chaitanya. So brahma chaitanyam ashritya eva vartamanatvar shakti riti cha vyapadishyate. Shakti and Shaktiman are always together. That is the idea here. Ittham prakrityadayaha pradhanasya avastha visheshatva pradhana swarupaya bhavanti. So all these are sankhyas pradhana. Sankhya called it as pradhana. Whether they are called as prakriti, maya, or whether it is called as prakriti, maya, ajnana, avidya, shakti, all these are other names for pradhana. And what is that pradhana? Tachya pradhana brahma chaitanyasya shakti. We'll stop here. This is Shakti of Brahma Chaitanya, and we'll continue from here in the next part. How, although Pradhana is not accepted as Shakti by the Sankhyas, we Vedantins take it as Shakti, and then based on this, we'll move further. Sukanityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurpe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyatunilam Aparam Sra Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevahanam Attonyat Iti Menishchitamatihi Tatsat. Mm-hmm.